lights and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Good evening and welcome. My name is Jean Reynolds and I supervise performing arts for Pinellas County Schools, and I am thrilled to see you here this evening. You are in for a wonderful, wonderful evening of music. I couldn't have a better job in the world than to work with these absolutely marvelous teachers who just define what it means to be an ensemble and work together to make an evening like this. Special thanks to Bonnie Mayak, who was kind of the master choreographer of this event because she was our component chairperson. Couldn't do it without her. Well deserved. Thanks also to you for your wonderful support and patience as we got going. I'd like to tell you that in our audience this evening, we've got wonderful people that make music alive in Pinellas County Schools. We're joined by some fabulous administrators this evening, including our superintendent of schools, Dr. Clayton Wilcox, and many, many principals who every day are the support that we need to do what we do best for kids. So please, a round of applause for them. Music is an art that exists in time, and it's something magic about it. Because when it's gone, although there's video and there's CDs, there's something magic about the moments. So given that, if you would silence your cell phones, because it is an art that exists in time, and we wouldn't want to do anything to really just ruin that magic. So I'd appreciate it if you would take care of that. There is videotaping. This will be shown on Channel 14. We'll talk a little bit more about that later. So just sit back and relax and enjoy. Finally, before we get started, thanks to you for your support. Instruments such as these, the risers, referendum dollars pay for those wonderful instruments. That's you and you're voting to do that for us, and it's making music grow, making theater programs better, and it's your generous support. I really, really appreciate it. The seat, yes, you can applaud for yourselves. We are delighted this evening to have as our MC someone who probably needs no introduction to you, this man you see on your TV every night. But this evening, I think he could really relate to all of you, because he was sitting in your chairs at one time, because his child is one of my colleagues who's a music teacher. I'd like to introduce our MC for the evening, Dick Fletcher from Channel 10.
Thank you all. It's really great to appear on the program. And since I am not the person you came to see and hear, please don't blame me for the cold night. The freeze warning does not include Pinellas County. I live in Pinellas County and I love it. World drumming has taken music education by storm. Based on the drumming traditions of the west coast of Africa and the Caribbean islands, this musical form is an oral tradition rooted in the African and Latin cultures. Respect, teamwork, and compliment are integral parts of world drumming. We're pleased to introduce Debbie Freeman, music specialist from Douglas L. Jamerson Elementary School, as the director of the Honors World Drumming Ensemble. Debbie received her bachelor's degree in music education from Florida State University. She's achieved level 2 certification in ORF Schule Work from the University of South Florida. She's a member of the Greater Tampa Bay Area ORF Chapter, Florida Music Educators Association, and the Music Educators National Conference. Mrs. Freeman, the 2004 Pinellas Elementary Music Educator of the Year, is a National Board Certified Teacher. Tonight, the drummers begin with a lively two-part piece called SpongeBob. It's gonna be good. It's inspired by the cartoon theme song. This piece utilizes body percussion to create a unique sound. George Jacobs' Middle Eastern drum ensemble follows. This traditional Lebanese drum routine features elbow slides and a djembe solo. One of the unique characteristics of world drumming is the incorporation of many intricate sound layers. This is exemplified in the five-part drum conversation of James Mader's African piece, Tikwe. Thank you. Didn't they do a great job? Thank you all very much. The international movement known as ORF was founded by German composers Karl Orff and Gunelt Tietmann. Their desire to make music accessible to all children led them to use exploration, experimentation, and creative expression as a way to experience and understand music. Our next selection was written by Florida resident Jim Solomon, whose name is synonymous with ORF. This high-energy Latin piece features the soprano recorders and a driving rhythm on the bongos. It gives me great pleasure to introduce the 2007 Honors ORF Ensemble performing Brisa Cambriando under the direction of Elizabeth McGilvery. Elizabeth McGilvery is no stranger to the podium. Mrs. McGilvery, music specialist at Perkins Elementary Center for the Arts, has conducted many ORF ensembles. Her performing groups have been featured on Pinellas County's television program, Student Measures. Elizabeth received her degree in music education from the University of South Florida and holds several ORF certifications. She is a founding member and president-elect of the Greater Tampa Bay ORF chapter. She is an involved member of the American ORF Schulwork Association, Florida Music Educators Association, and the Music Educators National Conference. This national board certified teacher and 2005 Pinellas County Music Educator of the Year is well respected in the world of ORF and continues to inspire teachers and students throughout the Pinellas District with her innovative compositions and arrangements. Our next piece was actually written by Elizabeth's mother, Iberia Johnston, Pinellas County's first Music Educator of the Year recipient. Iberia retired in 1994 after 29 years of teaching, motivating, and inspiring countless students and colleagues. In her piece, Celebration, the students will recreate the sound of a music box playing a gentle melody. Halfway through the composition, you'll hear the music gradually get slower. Just when you think it's time to applaud, Mrs. McGilvery will wind the students up and the music will continue. The Orff Ensemble will close with Heavy Roller, a high-energy piece from the country of Zimbabwe. Take notice of the multiple layers and repeated rhythmic patterns.
question between our chorus and our ensembles. It'll just take us just a moment. As we're doing that, just wanted to thank you, parents, for certainly your support of your kids, and just tell you what a pleasure it is for us to be able to feature some of our highest achieving students, which is what these all counties are all about, is taking students who are just wonderful students and giving them a chance to sing with other students who are equally high achieving students. This evening in dismissal, while I have you for a minute, the hardest thing for us is that the teachers care so much about their children that they worry if they don't know if you've picked them up. So we'll describe this to you again, but I believe, Stephanie, correct me if I'm wrong, it's schools beginning through A through O. There will be, your teacher will be out there with this A through N. There'll be a sign of your school, and the teacher will be there. They just want to make sure that they know that you've picked up the children. A colleague said to me last night, the scariest thing is, you know, I don't know if mom and dad picked up the students. So just give us one or two more minutes and we'll be ready and you can hear some wonderful children's voices. So if it's A through N, then obviously the rest of it, and it only it's W is on this side. So
and while we're going through the transition tonight, I know that you're all here and you're all proud of your children and your grandchildren. I'm reminded of seeing a bumper sticker that said, if you can read this, thank your teacher. If you're proud of your children, thank your children's teachers. They've done a wonderful job. Thank you. The conductor of our final group, Randolph Allen, received his Bachelor of Church Music from Samford University in Birmingham, Alabama. Mr. Allen has been a Pinellas County educator since 1995 and is currently the music specialist at James B. Sanderlin Elementary School in St. Petersburg. He was chosen as the Pinellas County Elementary Music Educator of the Year in 2003. Mr. Allen has served as the director of music at Annona United Methodist Church of Largo, Good Samaritan Church of Pinellas Park, and presently holds that position at Lakewood United Church of Christ in St. Petersburg. He is active in the American Orff Schulwerk Association, Florida Music Educators Association, and the Music Educators National Conference. In 1991, he began to work with the PAC Institute at Ruth Eckerd Hall, recently named the Marcia P. Hoffman Performing Arts Institute, where he continues to teach voice and piano. He is joined tonight by accompanist Karen Shockey, music specialist at Blanton and Westgate Elementary. The following words express the spirit of our next number. Let the heavens rejoice, let the sea roar, let the trees of the forest sing for joy. Shiru, Hebrew for sing, is an enthusiastic piece filled with syncopation and flowing harmonic lines. Please join me in welcoming the 2007 Pinellas All-County Honors Chorus as they sing a new song, Shiru.
Oh,
An anonymous poet has written, "Beauty is a song, a river of words that flows to touch the souls of others, a cascade of melody to lift the spirit of others, a pool of harmony to refresh the lives of others. Surround yourself in beauty as the chorus sings for the beauty of the earth." The Orphan World Drumming Ensembles accompany the following South African melody. South African music has a strong vocal tradition where children learn to sing at a very early age. The movements are subtle and graceful. In Freedom Is Coming, the lyrics and musical phrases combine to create a recurring melody. Why am I doing this? Tonight I have the answer in the next introduction. A world united in peace, what an inspiration for our future. We continue now with Dona Nobis Pacem, Latin for grant us peace. Dona Nobis Pacem is a beautiful contemplative two-part melody. Listen to the chorus exchange their musical ideas of peace.
Dona Nobis.
That was great. Held that last note longer than I thought. Composer Aaron Copland embraced the folk music of America. He set the old American songs, his set of old American songs is comprised of three folk tunes from the 19th century. Tonight we'll hear one of the most recognizable melodies. The Shaker hymn, Simple Gifts, reflects the notion that the beauty of life lies in its simplicity. I'm really enjoying the music, and I notice some of the chorus is actually doing what I do, and that's sneaking a peek at the big screen to see what you look like on TV. Your kids are sounding great. In the winter of 1932, Edward Kennedy Ellington, better known as Duke Ellington, released the tune, It Don't Mean a Thing If It Ain't Got That Swing. This significant work marked a departure from the hot jazz of the 1920s to the swing music of the 1930s. Let's hear the chorus, Give That Rhythm Everything You've Got.
You got
Boy, everyone got into that one, didn't they? Anat Blum, an Israeli student, wrote, "If you look around, you can hear a sound. We are singing in the chorus of the world. All nations sing it together. All people are gathered to sing about a nation of the world." The United Nations has designated September 21st of each year as the International Day of Peace. This Day of Peace was commissioned to commemorate this occasion.
I wasn't, but I am. I want to let you know your students have been such a joy to work with. And tonight for me is dedicated to my father. He's not able to be here tonight. He's home, sick in bed. And these students have been very supportive for me. They know about my dad being sick, and every rehearsal I come, they ask, many of them ask how my dad's doing. Many of you have asked how my father is, and I really thank you for that. My father has been a very big influence on why I'm here tonight, and tonight, again, is just dedicated to him, and I'm very thankful for that.
On behalf of the Pinellas County music educators, I thank you for all coming to share in this evening of song. The talented children who perform tonight exemplify the quality of music education in Pinellas County. Next year, your children will have the opportunity to explore the many facets of middle school. Each one is strongly encouraged to enroll in a music or arts class. John F. Kennedy once said, "The life of the arts, far from being a distraction to the life of the nation, is closer to the center of a nation's purpose and is the test of the quality of a nation's civilization." The importance music plays in the total education of your children cannot be underestimated. Thank you for your continued support of music in Pinellas County Schools. At the conclusion of the program, we ask that parents remain seated until the children leave the sanctuary and I can get out of the parking lot and go back to work. The chorus will be dismissed by row to the entryway where they will meet their teachers. For your child's safety, we ask that you go to the entryway to pick them up. Now that takes us to our final number. Break forth, sing aloud, and play music. We leave you with a reprise of the Hebrew song, Shiru.
Thank you again, and if you just let us get the children out there, we will be delighted to greet you. Have a wonderful evening and a safe drive.